about. So we were talking the relation E was equal to, in the last class, this is what I think I have already given you, E is equal to mc square in, and that can be written as m0c square divided by root of 1 minus v square by c square. Okay. So from this, how are we going to get this mass energy relation? And from that, what we are doing is a momentum energy. From here, we are going to derive momentum and energy relation. Momentum and energy relation is what we are doing. So now how do we go about doing this? Now, this is your equation number one. Then the momentum, whatever we are talking about is with respect to relativistic things. So the relative momentum P is given by mass into velocity. So when you take mass from this relation, what will you get? You get m0v by root of 1 minus v square by c square. This is your relative momentum. Now, multiply equation 2 by c, that is nothing but the velocity of light. I'll tell you why we are multiplying. By doing this, what am I getting? What I'm getting is onto the left, it is P into C, which is equal to already M0 is there, isn't it? M0 VC by root of 1 minus V square by C square under root. This is your equation number 3. What are we doing with this? If PC is given by this, okay. So we get what is known as the relativistic momentum. Okay. Let me just come back to this equation. I will come back to this equation in a little while now. So before that, I think I'll come back to that. Einstein's mass energy relation, we will do this and we will go back to that. So to do that, let me again start with m is equal to m0 root 1 minus v squared by c squared. Then, this is according to the special theory of relativity, mass m is moving with a velocity v. Mass m is moving with a velocity of v. So now, let us try to, we say mass is no longer constant. This is no longer constant. It is a function of velocity. This is what we have already confirmed, isn't it? This is what we have already confirmed. So, that means, let us differentiate equation 1 on both sides, with respect to v, because we say mass is varying with respect to velocity. So can I write it as dm is equal to m naught is constant into this 1 minus v square by c square can be written as raised to the power 4. When you take it to the denominator numerator, it looks something like this. So you write this as m naught into the square, this is to the power minus half. So when you take the derivative, what do I get? Minus half into 1 minus v square by c square minus half, okay, and minus 1, that is minus 3 by 2 into what is the derivative of v square by c square? It is nothing but, what is the derivative of that? That is nothing but 2v by c square, because there is a negative sign, this is going to be negative. So you get it as minus 2v by c square into dv. Okay, so first of all, then you can also write this as dm is equal to m naught into, what is happening, this two gets cancelled, this is minus becomes plus, and this 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 3 by 2 can be written as 1 minus v square by c square minus 1 into 1 minus c square to the power minus half. Thereby, this will become equal to 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 1 into 1 minus v squared by c square, maybe you write this as power half, this as minus 1 into what is left, v dv by c square. Now this can be further written as, this is nothing but equal to m0 divided by 1 minus v square by c square under root. So this factor now can be written as, this can now be written, isn't it, m naught by this can be written as m into, what is this, 1 minus v square by c square to the power minus 1. So it is nothing but divided by 1 minus v square by c square plus 1 into v dv by c square. This is m v dv by c square minus v square into c square by c square. Thereby, what am I reading? These two get cancelled. So what you get is, what you are getting here is dm is equal to mv dv by c square minus v square. This is what you are doing. This is how mass is varying with respect to what? With respect to velocity. This can also be written as equal to mv dv is equal to c square minus v square d of m. So let's call this as equation number 1. This is 1. Okay, let's call this as equation number 2. Now, you all know work energy theorem. What is the work energy theorem? Even in central forces we came across. So, work done according to this is proportional to change in kinetic energy, a change in energy. Okay, then wasn't the work done. How do you define the work done as? Work done can be expressed as a product of, it's a square product of force into displacement. So if a force acting on a body, if a force F acting on a body displaces it by dx, then the work done can be written as F dot dx. Okay, so that means since work done is F dx, according to work energy theorem, according to work energy theorem, work done is F dx and that should be change in the kinetic energy, isn't it? So now how do you write this as? You will write this as du, the change in the kinetic energy is equal to F dx. Okay, so let's call this as, I think, equation 3. This is equation 3. So when you have this here like this, what else can you do? What else can you do? You have written work energy theorem. You also have written force into distance, right? Then equate these two. According to Newton's laws of motion, the second law of motion what you are talking about can be written as, how do you write the second law of motion as? That the force is nothing but, according to the second law of motion, according to Newton's second law, this is the force which is external, is causing a displacement of dx. So what is it that you can say? This force which is acting on this is, the force external according to this law is proportional to rate of change of momentum, which can be written as d by dt of mass into velocity. When we derived these relations, we kept m as constant, but m is now a variable. Therefore, you can write d by dt of m. So therefore, you can write this as, this is differential of a product. If this is a differential of a product, that means at a time we will consider only one. So that means m dv by dt plus what will you write? V dm by dt. M dv by dt plus V dm by dt. Okay. Now, so that means this is your F. Now, du is equal to F dot dx, isn't it? You have du is equal to F dot dx from which equation? Equation number 3. So, from substituting in equation 3, what we get is, let us see what we get. We get du, what are we writing? Equation 4 we are writing du. So du therefore will now be equal to, instead of F what will you write? Equation 4. M dv by dt plus V dm by dt into dx. So which can further be written as equal to? How do you write this as? You can write this as m dv. M dv. Can I write it as dx by dt? I am taking dx by dt. Similarly, v dm into dx by dt. By writing like this, I can replace dx by dt with velocity. That is why I am writing it like this. So now when you write like this, these are all actually partial derivatives only, because it is a function of two variables. So you can write this as, what will you write this as? Now this is dx by dt, so this can be written as mv dv plus v square dm. This is your equation 5. So what am I getting? I am getting du, isn't it? In the previous example, in the previous equation, you have mv dv also. You must have written mv dv. What was mv dv? Mv dv from this equation 2. Can you see an equation 2 here? See this equation 2. From this equation 2, mv dv is equal to c square minus v square dm. Again you have, what do you have here? Mv dv. So now you can write, substitute equation 2 into this, substituting equation 2, what do you get? On to the right you have du, and in place of mv dv, what will you write? We will write c square minus v square dm plus v square dm. So this v square dm, this v square dm gets cancelled, then you just get it as c square by dm. C square dm, I'm sorry. So now integrate this equation 6 on either side. Integrating on either side, what are you doing? The change in the kinetic energy d of u from 0 to u is equal to c square dm. M is changing from rest mass to m, therefore this is equal to m minus m naught into c square. This is the equation. So m c square minus m0 c square, this we call as rest mass energy. And what is very important is, this is, what is this? This is relativistic mass. So this is relativistic, the total energy of the particle having relativistic mass. This factor indicates the energy of a body having relativistic mass. So now we will come back to this equation, what I started. So we are starting with momentum relation, E is equal to mc square, and m is written as m0 c square by this, and relativistic. We are trying now to find a relation between momentum and energy. So momentum energy relation, if a body is moving with relativistic mass, the energy possessed is relativistic energy, the momentum possessed also is relativistic momentum. So now how do we get this? To get this, we multiply with mass into velocity is a momentum. Here mass is m, velocity is it's moving with the velocity of light, so c, so pc is its energy. So now what will you get? Pc is what you are getting. Now what can we do? Equation number, first equation, this is your equation 1. So let us square this equation. When you square this equation, what do we get? E square is equal to m0c square c to the power 4 by 1 minus v square by c square. Isn't it? So now subtract that equation 1 minus 3. You are doing 1, you are subtracting. What we are doing now is you are subtracting 1 and 3. Subtracting 3 from 1, what will we get? It was e, isn't it? E square. Suppose you square this also, then what will we get? P square c square is equal to m0 square v square c square by 1 minus v square by c square. Now, this is an important relation. E square minus p square c square. What will we get? Let us see. What will you get? What was equation 1 when you square? What did we have? You had m0 square. Excuse me. M0 square c to the power 4 by 1 minus v square by c square. By squaring, that radical sign of square root is eliminated. That is why we are taking the square of this. Minus, this is what we are getting, m0 square v square c square by 1 minus v square by c square. So what are you getting out of this? So now you simplify this. What is common here? 1 minus v square by c square is common. So you can write this as v square minus p square c square is equal to what is common here? M0 square c power 4, let us take. M0 square c power 4, suppose you take it common. 1 minus v square is not there. V square by c square, whole thing divided by 1 minus v square by c square. So what happens? These two get cancelled. What am I getting? E square minus p square c square is equal to, what am I getting? Equal to m0 square c to the power 4 r. Very important relation. E square is equal to p square c square plus m0 square c to the power 4. I think this is equation number 6. This equation shows relativist equation between, this is energy, this term is energy, this term is momentum. So this gives a relation between energy and momentum. So this diagram is relations.